Crescent Hotel by Lee Coggins from Medford, Oregon. Out behind the ranch house sitting on a hill, that once busy outhouse stands, neglected there and still. Now I remember in my youth that wasn't always that way. Everybody went there, at least once a day. I first come to know it when I was quite small. They were the box for me to stand on. The seat was way too tall. My two older sisters, they always complained about the dampness on the seat because of my erratic hand. For paper, we used a catalog from the past year. Can you remember how them slick sheets always left the snare? The door opened eastwards away from winter storm. The sun was shining, the place stayed at least half warm. On a cold morning, we learned don't be first to grab the seat, but you'd be ready to jump on next while this old body heat. I recollect in the summertime, it was kind of getting warm, and that space below the seat attracted a bee swarm. Now, Pa, he went strolling out to do his morning thing. In the very end of his private park, got a terrible sting. Folks still swear they could hear him yell all the way to town. And he tried to fire and move them bees, but he burnt that outhouse down. And Ma made him build another before the week was through. Out behind the barn. But before the week was done, it out behind the barn, we're just too far for her to run. Now, Ma was sitting out there one day in early spring. Maybe thumbing through the catalog, maybe looking at frilly things. And Pa, he was cleaning out the barn using a green broom, spreading that manure out to make the grass grow green. Something spooked them horses. I heard Pa yell. I slammed the wagon into the outhouse to get hard on the camera. Slid the thing backwards with a terrible lurch. Ma started using words that you don't hear in church. She comes storming out, she was going to give Pa the fits. And she dropped waist deep in. It was violence. Uncle Henry, he was our family drunk. He went staggered out of that outhouse one night and stepped upon skunk. He comes storming back in the house, and I can remember him tell. It's time to move that outhouse, but it sure does smell. And Grandpa, he partied with his cowboy friends, and he come home late. They'd been drinking Whitey's moonshine. When he was sick, sick kid, we heard him go to the outhouse. We heard him away. We never missed them false teeth till breakfast that next day. We fished him out with a garden hoe. We scrubbed him awful clean. We tried to put him back in his mouth, he turned pale green. He started for near a week on gruel and things real thin. We had to get him blind drunk on his own shine to get him in again. Now the past old outhouse is faded away. This kind of business goes on inside today. You don't get a chill. There's a nice, warm, even heat. You only have to look out for splinters in the seat. Oh, no, it's just a sorry shame for sure. Gotta make up your own excitement in the bathroom and home.